There's something I want to talk to you about. Something important. I could have died in that pod, back on the Nautiloid. You could have died, spending precious moments trying to free me, but you did it anyway. I owe you my life. Twice over, in fact. You supported me against Lazel. I may not have survived that night without you. I'm trying to say that you've earned my trust in a way very few ever have. I want that to mean something. I want you to know more about me, at least from what I can remember. As long as I've prayed to Lady Shah, I've wished to serve her as a Dark Justiciar. There is scarcely a greater way to fully dedicate yourself to Lady Shah, save perhaps if you become the head of her church. To become a Dark Justiciar is to become the Night Singer's sword arm, her implement with which she will cast down the unbelievers and win the final battle to restore her perfect, endless darkness. It's all I ever wanted. I prayed it was my calling. But Mother forbid me from seeking to prove myself worthy of the rank. She said I was not ready. Not my mother, I should add. The Mother Superior, head of Lady Shah's enclave in Baldur's Gate. Sometimes I wonder if she would ever deem me ready. I owe her everything, and I only wish to serve, yet she can prove inscrutable. I don't know. Perhaps if I succeed in my mission and reach Baldur's Gate. Hope has little place amongst Lady Shah's children. It's an illusion, a distraction. For this, I hope my time will yet come.
Dog wags his tail, a small bag clenched between his teeth. He gives in and surrenders his find to you. Scratch's tongue lolls out.
Plain, everything is eternal.
It will be my home soon enough, should Vlakith will it.
Wait. These markings. Tirsu's script scratched in the ground. A creche must be nested in the temple below. We must go there at once. Githyanki writing. Every word a wheel. Every letter a spoke. The most powerful texts are engraved in slate. Some so ancient, only the most erudite Gish can read them. Very well. You may lead. But if we stray too far that our chance is lost, I'll make my way there alone.
Blessed be you, pilgrim. Take respite now in the dawn's loving gaze.
Looks like Lathander, god of the dawning sun.
I warn you, I'm exceptionally well armed.
Ah, a friendly face. Oh, you are a sweet, sweet blessing, my dear. You know, I've had nothing but trouble all day. I've been accosted, chased, insulted. Look over there. Do you see that wretched little hive? Oh, it certainly looks that way. But inside, it is swarming with brutish, stupid, rude Githyanki.
Brutish and rude by your wretched standards, but stupid. Kchoki.
Your charming companion would call it a creche, but it was built on what remained after the Githyanki slaughtered all of the monks. I'd call it a murderous training camp.
Acutely observed on both counts.
Honestly, I was doing them a favor offering to buy one of their eggs. And how am I repaid? Attacked and run off like some transient. The Society of Brilliance asked me to acquire one of their roe so they can incubate it and, once it hatches, raise the spawn in their tradition.
Please, do enlighten me. What is this tradition?
The Society believes a Githyanki raised in a peaceful, nurturing environment can overcome its violent nature. I'm sure your friend would agree. A Githyanki is as likely to forsake its violent nature as a gnome is to fly. You've been sipping from the same goblet as the Society. Perhaps you'd be willing to help them, to prove your point. They may have chased me away, but surely the Gith would welcome a person with such sympathetic views to their creche. And once inside, you could simply purloin an egg.
Steal one of Gith's own. I will slit your throat for even suggesting it.
I'm not talking to you. You'll be well compensated, of course. Just bring me an egg. Pity. You'd have become rather rich had you the proper sense. Should you change your mind, you know where to find me.
I'm not one to admire a view. This time, well.
Approach the fairy in Lathander's grace. May his gaze shine upon you, pilgrim.
Impossible. Good. With great effort, great reward. Or so I hope.
Thank you. Still breathing, despite everything.
That's enough! On your feet.
Where are you taking us?
If this is about that weapon your friend was talking about, we don't have it and we don't know shit about it.
Silence! Move!
No. No, 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 I'm not going in there. I won't.
Anyone want to join her? As I thought. Through the doors. Now! The captain is expecting you.
Forward. Carefully. These cultists have the creche on high alert.
Undead, crushed underfoot. The Dawn Lord certainly knows how to make space for new life. So the Githyanki aren't fond of the cultists. Could be a good thing.
Within the artifact, a feeling stirs. Uncertainty.
Your curiosity is getting the better of you. Do not let it. Stay away from the Githyanki. They're hunting you. They want the artifact. They'll stop at nothing to take it from you.
Eager for battle.
At least things have stayed interesting.
Magic's out of the question, then. No telling how they'll react.
I am fury. I am death.
With haste.
two steps at a time.
Time to strike.
Wonder if the gods are watching me. Keep me out.
You've a particular way with words, Gale. Perhaps oration suits you more than battle.
They're not mutually exclusive. The weave is served best with a dash of eloquence.
You strike me as cleverer than most Istiki Gale. Multiple tutors, I should guess.
Many a wise man and woman indeed. Waterdeep is the home of myriad scholars.
Ah, the City of Splendors. Spent a whole fleet's wake there with my father. What a delight.
To the nearest library.
Action, not reaction.
Let's get going.
Action, not reaction.
I shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times. That kobold reeks of spirits. Fire could be explosive. Still on my feet. Don't waste a step.
This is my time.
Exhausted. A good night's sleep would do me wonders. Thank you.
Who's in charge of the Mind Flayers, Lazelle? Is there a Squid King or something?
No. Each Geth is servant to an Elder Brain. No king unites elders. Only their collective tyranny.
A Mind Flayer monarch? Imagine that. Such a thing could shatter worlds.
Dawnmaster Vasaid. Dawnmaster Welkin Glory. The monarch. monastery's notable keepers adorn these intricate panels. Lathendarian monasteries of this size were usually overseen by Dawn Masters, esteemed members of the clergy. The reconsecration of the monastery, conducted by Dawn Master Seed. Evensong before the Zenith Day, celebrated by Dawn Master Stockhold. Dawn Master Vasaid wielding. The rest of the inscription and picture has shattered away. Dawn Master Welking Glory beckons forth the rising sun in Lathander's name.
Can a squiddy go solo, Lisa? You know, break free of their master.
Renegades are not unheard.
Forgive me. We have to fire the lance.
Looks like a magic mouth spell. That voice probably belongs to someone long gone.
At your side.
Your ground! Keep them busy! The thunder, forgive me. We have to fire the lance.
remarkably long-lasting one at that. Blade will not bend. Finding my way. Survival is all that matters.
Victory awaits.
Powerful-looking piece of armament. Used on those Githyanki, perhaps?
Fallen Githyanki warrior. A Kresh must be close. Fallen Githyanki warrior. A Kresh must.
Thank you.
Sounds important. Could it still be here somewhere?